This is the Dominoes on a chessboard puzzle. Here's how it goes. Let's say I give you a chessboard, but I'm gonna take off the top left and bottom right corners so we only have 62 squares. Now I'm also gonna give you 31 dominoes to place. Each domino covers exactly 2 squares like this. So here's the question. Is it possible to cover every square on the board with dominoes? By the way, you can place dominoes sideways too, not just diagonally. Also, they can't overlap. So with that being said, do you think it's possible to cover every square? Pause the video if you want to figure it out for yourself. So the answer is actually no, it's impossible to cover every square with the dominoes. And there's a clever way to immediately tell that. Let me place a domino on the board and pay close attention to the colors it covers. Here it's one light and one dark. Here it's also one light and one dark. Same thing here. Wherever we put a domino, it's going to cover one light square and one dark square. So to cover the entire board with our 31 dominoes, we would need 31 light and 31 dark squares. But if we count them up, we actually only have 30 light and 32 dark. That's because both squares I removed at the beginning of the video were light squares. And that's why the puzzle is impossible. Now, see if you can use a similar technique to solve this problem. First, let's start with the same chessboard, but I'm going to remove these 4 squares this time. And instead of a domino, we're going to use this shape called a T-shaped tetromino. The rules are the same. You can place tetrominoes wherever you want and in any orientation as long as none overlap. The question is also the same. Is it possible to cover every square? Once again, pause the video if you want to try it. It turns out that this is impossible too. So how can we prove it? I think a good place to start would be to count up the light and dark squares just like in the last puzzle. Here we have 30 light and 30 dark. Which, by the way, means we could easily tile this with dominoes. But with the tetrominoes, it's not so simple. If we again look at the colors they cover, we can notice that there are 2 different types. Some cover 3 dark and 1 light, like this, this, and this. And the others cover 1 dark and 3 light, like this, this, and this. Now, here's the key. Since we need an equal number of light and dark squares to tile the whole board, 30 apiece, we need to use an equal number of the 2 types. That way, we're covering 4 dark squares for every 4 light squares. But in this puzzle, that's actually impossible, because 4 doesn't go evenly into 30, so it's impossible to keep placing 4 light and 4 dark squares at a time and reach 30 of each. You'd reach 28 of each color and then have no way to fill the remaining 2. So that's why the puzzle is impossible.